Oh, it's another video about Patrick's Corvette. Nope, actually, a car that's my true workhorse that I've had for going on 20 years now is over here. See this sweet little modest, very pretty little red Mustang? That's Ruby. Ruby has been with me for 20 years. I bought her new. She hasn't been getting much attention lately. I recently finally cleaned out the garage so she can be in here at night along with the little demon that I call Lenore. This is little Lenore. Hey, I hear Dom behind me. He wants to come out. Hold on, Dom. But I wanted to show you Ruby. This is an amazing car, and I want to share it because it's a success story with a car with 256,000. That's right, a quarter of a million miles on it. And how you can, have a beater without it looking like a beater. Let's do a little walk around. I did some basic things to it, like I put fog lights and a chin spoiler on it, kind of spruce it up. But I like stock, although these are 17-inch rims from a GT99. They came with some silly little 15-inch. Now you've got straight pipes on here with Flowmaster. Just did some little things to it. You know, when you have a car for 20 years, you have to do a few things like hit this metal fuel door. This is my big so, like I said, it's got a lot of miles, and she's done great. I love this hood, this little sculpted hood. It always reminds me of, this is like the poor man's Ferrari hood. Little scoop on it. I like the side scoops too. Let's go inside. But, yeah, I mean, when I saw the 99s, I drove by the lot back in 99, and there was this very car sitting on the lot. Comes with a nice 100-watt stereo. Look, cassette and CD. So that's cool to me. It came with this little leather CD holder, too. Yep, I still listen to CDs, man. I just like the sound quality. And, you can pack 12 CDs in here. That's like, how many songs? Like, it's 12 times 10. And 120. How many songs do you need? That's a trip to LA and back, and you can't even listen to them all, because I've tested that out. But at any rate, so, this car was my first new car that I have bought, and my last. Like I said, I've kept it for 20 years. Bought it in Akron, Ohio at Spitzer Ford with 19 miles on it. And like I said, when I saw this body style on the lot, it's a 5-speed. I was suddenly a Mustang guy. I wasn't before. I put leather seat covers on it, basically to protect the upholstery. But I like the way these look too. But they do—they're protecting the fabric. There's no tears in the carpet or the upholstery. So I drove across the country. Went through the Nevada Salt Flats, which is when you're taking 80 west, you'll do that. So I got to open her up when she was brand new. That was in 2000, so she was only about 6 months old, and I pegged her out. You know on speedometers how it'll say, like this one says 120. It does more than that. There's a little peg after 120. Double peg, is that 130? I hit that. So I held it for what, 5 minutes or so, and then I changed the oil when I got to Wyoming because it was black. But, yeah, this car does 130 miles an hour very nicely, too, I might add. It doesn't lift up on the front end or anything weird. It's got enough downforce aerodynamics. That's what I liked about these Mustangs is so far, even to date, I think it's the most aerodynamic design they've come up with because they started making them with the big fat grille in 2005. But let's look at the engine. There's lots of stories about these Essex V6 3.8 liters. There's the story that it was made from a V8 block and they chopped off two cylinders. It was the V8 that was in the Ford Windstar. Remember minivans? Sorry about that. Excuse me. But what they did with this V6 3.8, these go all the way back to the 80s. This 3.8 V6. They had them in the Ford Granadas, which my dad had. But it didn't have this, a split port intake manifold. And this gave it another 50 horsepower. So those old Ford Granadas had about only like 100 and some odd horsepower. But this brought it up to a good 200 horsepower. And then you've got an intake, cold air intake on here, something I put on, obviously. That brings the horsepower up easily, a good 15 to 20. And the Flowmaster straight pipes bring it up another 15 to 20. So it's in the mid 200 horsepower range. It's a stray cat that's talking over here. Where is he? Oh, he's behind that truck over there. Hear him? Drives my cat nuts. So yeah, this is a perky little engine. It'll pull nicely, and it's kind of got a hidden amount of power. The power isn't on the low end. When you're just driving around, it's not much faster than your average V6 Camry, you know. It pulls nicely, it's not slow. But on the top end, you can accelerate in fifth gear, long story short. You can accelerate in fifth gear up a good 20-degree incline, which is what I have to take when I come home from Oakland. When you're coming up the hill on Highway 4, there's a good long incline that's, 3 to 4 miles. And I can pass cars in fifth gear in this thing. So the top end horsepower is really nice. And I'll pass that V6 Camry, for instance, you know. So it has more power than that. So that's what I would say about this car, is that I wouldn't, you know, compare it to a GT or a Shelby, of course, or anything like that. But if you compare it to the average car, it's faster. So that's where it sits. But I have another theory as to what Ford should have done to market these better. And my theory is, Ford should have called this the GT, and I'll explain why. The GT stands for Grand Touring, or Grand Turismo, right? Which is a car that has, it's a sports car with all the accoutrements like air conditioning, plush interior, stereo. That's, by definition, what a GT is. That's really this car. Because it has the muscle, but it's comfortable, and it's got the mileage. This car will do, it'll get 30 miles to the gallon on the freeway. So I think they should have badged the V6, which is now the four-cylinder. They don't have a V6, as the GT, and they should have badged the V8 version as an RT, a road and track, a true racing Mustang. So they should have had those as RTs, the V6s as a GT. And then, of course, you got your Cobra and your Shelbys and your SVTs for the special, you know, super, super nice V8s. But that would have given this more, you know, character. But they didn't give it anything. They just called it the Mustang, you know. And it just silently had the V6 in it with no special little logo, you know. But they could have made these the GT. That's my theory for it. You should have done that, because it is by definition a GT, a grand touring car. But anyways, that's little Ruby, my workhorse. quarter of a million miles, still going strong. It's probably paid for itself about four times over, and I just thought I'd share that because little Lenore, my demon here, she gets a lot of attention, and as she should. She's the new kid on the block, the new old kid. But, yeah, my babies.